Join us today on our fourth expedition to the volcano. Lots of things have changed. The crater has widened and the lava production has increased beyond 13 cubic meters per second. In response, the government of Iceland has attempted to build a wall. Is it enough? My dad is joining us once again thanks to your overwhelming response on our last video. But for now, welcome to our fourth trip to the volcano. Please enjoy. We start the hike from the usual spot, parking at Geldingadalir. But now there is a change. You have to pay to park here. Another thing that's new, there is a road now suitable for trucks that goes all the way up to the volcano. This does not mean that the public is allowed to drive here. It's only for personnel.
They are leaving. They have given up.
That's hilarious.
So there's a new way. We used to go this, now it's a way.
The volcano has never been this accessible.
So we walked like this.
Here's the wall that you have heard of. A pretty sad attempt to stop a volcano. The lava has to go somewhere, and it won't simply flow back into the volcano. So this wall, it's gonna flow over it. Just a matter of time. Remember last video when we were standing all the way here by the lava front? Yeah, well, the lava has advanced significantly along with the increased magma production. It is very close to the walking path now. So the spot that we were standing on in the last video is completely buried under molten lava now.
Alright, how many times have you been here?
15.
Wow!
First I was here when the eruption was 2 days old.
Wow.
And it was a really small wall then.
Very cool.
Just one crater.
Nice. And then you always want to come back here, so you go every weekend or something like that?
I'm completely hooked.
Yeah. So you've been watching this thing grow.
Yeah.
Same.
It's getting quite huge.
Very huge. That's true. I mean, that's the reality now. Yeah, no, that wall is done for.
So big, man.
So huge.
Even bigger than me.
Okay, action.
Okay, so thank you all for your positive feedback on our last video. So we're back at the volcano. It's been 3 weeks, and there have been some changes in the eruption. The output has increased by about 100%, so it's now up to 15 cubic meters per second from 5 to 6. So anywhere between 10 and 15 cubic meters per second. This also means that the total volume of the lava has increased, has doubled since we were here the last time. And the lava now extends more than 2 square kilometers. It's also getting much thicker. The average thickness 2 weeks ago was maybe in the order of 11, 12 meters. Now it's certainly up to 15, 20. And there have been some efforts to try and divert the lava flow, because there is a risk that it will flow down towards the coast and destroy some infrastructure on the way, some cables and roads. But this is probably not gonna be successful. You cannot really stop a lava flow. So gravity never rests, and the lava just flows on. Another thing with this eruption is that the kind of intensity has changed too. Now there are intervals of maybe 6 to 10 minutes of little activity. Well, there is flow from the crater, but there is very little effusive activity. And then in between, we have maybe a minute or two of quite intense activity, where there are lava fountains sprouting maybe up to 100 meters up into the air. This is because of release of gases. So when the magma comes up the feeding channel, it's under great pressure, but as it comes closer to the surface and the feeding channel perhaps widens somewhat, the pressure falls, and that means that the magma starts to degas. So there are big bubbles of gas that form, and they will rise to the surface through the pool of lava which is in the crater. And that means that there's an overflow from the crater. There's a magma that's spilling out because of this big bubble of gas that's rising up through the column. And once these gas bubbles reach the surface, it boils. And that's when we see these fountains or curtains of molten lava that are thrown up high into the air. Quite spectacular.
Last time we were here, the volcano shot up to a record of 1,000 feet up in the air. At that time, we had to deal with falling shards of rock. Now it's not shooting as high, so no falling shards, which allows me to film with my drone. Quick update, only a few hours after we left the site, the wall actually did get breached. The wall further from the walking path got lava flowing over it. Some people on Facebook shared video of this happening, which I am very, very fortunate to be allowed to use in this video. So thank you so much for your contribution. So what does this mean for the future of the lava? Well, it means that eventually the lava is going to reach the southern point of Iceland, and on the way it's going to cross some infrastructure. Roads and cables will be destroyed. So what are we going to do about it? I don't know. Build another wall? I guess I will just have to monitor the situation and I will update you as the lava gets closer and closer. Hey, it's John Bear. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end of the video. It means a lot. If you haven't seen our previous videos, then I really recommend them, especially the one with my dad where he explains the science behind this volcano and why Iceland has so many volcanoes in the first place. If you want to see more volcano videos, then stay tuned. There's going to be one where we roast some marshmallows at the lava front. That's pretty fun. If you want to see that, make sure you subscribe. If you want to support the channel, we have a Redbubble page where you can buy photographs as prints and other merch as well. So it's a nice way to give your volcano-loving friends something nice and support the channel while you're at it. I'm John Bear, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.